Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvenni. I am happy to meet you in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on gate question papers in mechanical engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 28 on the discussion. And the subject we are going to discuss is refrigeration. So in this lecture, we solve a few questions from the refrigeration chapter from various gate question papers. The first question is from 2000. In a vapor compression refrigeration system, liquid to suction heat exchanger is used to keep COP constant, prevent the liquid refrigerant from entering the compressor, subcool the liquid refrigerant leaving the condenser, subcool the vapor refrigerant from the evaporator. So among the four answers, the correct answer is subcool the liquid refrigerant leaving the condenser. So that is the purpose of the liquid to suction heat exchanger. The next question from 2000 question again. Global warming is caused by ozone, carbon dioxide, nitrogen and carbon monoxide. So this is obvious, it is a simple question. The global warming is caused by carbon dioxide. So the carbon dioxide emission from major contributor to the automobile. So automobile combustion, wherever there is combustion, there will be CO2 generation. But particularly in the case of carbon dioxide, the automobile emission is more. So the global warming is caused by the carbon dioxide. A gas having negative Joule-Thomson coefficient when mu is less than 0, when throttled, will become cooler, warmer, remain at the same temperature, either be cooler or warmer depending upon the type of the gas. The Joule-Thomson coefficient is given by mu equal to dp by dt at constant enthalpy. Now here, when Joule-Thomson, when mu is less than 0, throttling process dp is negative. And then dt is positive. Dp, pressure is negative. Pressure decreases in the direction in the through the throttling device. So the temperature is positive. So where for positive temperature, the fluid become warmer. A positive value of Joule-Thomson coefficient of the fluid means. So positive value, mu is greater than 0. The temperature drops during the throttling process. So mu is positive means, Joule-Thomson coefficient is greater than 0, positive means greater than 0. So the temperature drops during the throttling process. Dt is negative. In window air conditioner, the expansion device used is capillary tube, thermostatic expansion valve, automatic expansion valve, float valve. So the correct answer is capillary tube. So this is from 2004 question paper. The next question is also from 2004 question paper. Environment friendly refrigerant R134A is used in the new generation domestic refrigerator. Its chemical formula is, we have CHClF2, C2Cl3F3, C2Cl2F4, C2H2F4. So the correct answer is C2H2F4. So we will see how in the next slide. So R134A, the chemical formula is C2H2F4. So we will see here. The refrigeration is designation. So how the refrigeration is designated? So by the formula CM, HN, CLP and FQ. So C is the carbon, H is the hydrogen, Cl is the chlorine, F is the fluorine. So in this equation, N plus P plus Q equal to 2M plus 2. That condition is to be satisfied. Where N is the, M is the number of carbon atoms, N is the number of hydrogen atoms, P is the number of chlorine atoms, and Q is the number of fluorine atoms. The refrigerant number, so it is written like this, R, M minus 1, N plus 1 and Q. Now we have R134A. So R134A, so this M minus 1 is number of carbon, M minus 1 equal to 1. Because in the formula first number is M minus 1, so M minus 1 equal to 1, so M equal to 2. Second number, N plus 1, number of hydrogen atom equal to 3. So, N equal to 2. And they refer to this equation. And the third number is Q. see R m minus 1 n plus 1 Q. So third number is Q. So Q equal to 4 and P is number of fluorine atom is not given here. So the number of fluorine atom is 4. So R134a equal to C2, refer to this equation, C2 H n equal to 2 H2 P is equal to 0 and FQ, Q equal to 4. So C2 H2 F4 is the chemical formula for R134a. The next question from 2004 question paper, which of the following is a CFC refrigerant? So CFC is the chlorofluorocarbon refrigerant. So the answer is 502. So 502 R502 is the CFC refrigerant. The next question is from 2009 question paper. In an ideal vapor compression refrigeration cycle, the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the following states given as inlet to the condenser 283 kilojoules per kilogram, exit of the condenser 116 kilojoules per kilogram, exit of the evaporator 232 kilojoules per kilogram. The COP of the cycle is, we have four options, 2.27, 2.75, 3.27, 3.75. So the answer is 2.27. So we will see how in the next slide. So the ideal vapor compression cycle is shown here. The specific enthalpy at the inlet to the condenser H3 equal to 283 kilojoules per kilogram. Exit to the condenser H4 equal to H1 equal to 116 kilojoules per kilogram. Exit to the evaporator H2 equal to 232 kilojoules per kilogram. Now the COP of the cycle. So the refrigeration effect, the heat transfer, heat absorbed in the refrigeration evaporator. So the H2 minus H1 divided by compressor work H3 minus H2. So for process 4 to 1, it is a throttling process. For throttling process, H1 equal to H4. So the COP equal to H2 minus H4 divided by H3 minus H2. So substituting the values, 232 minus 116 divided by 283 minus 232 equal to 2.27. That is the COP of the vapor compression refrigeration cycle. The next question from 2019 question paper, consider an ideal vapor compression refrigeration cycle. If the throttling process is replaced by an isentropic expansion process, keeping all the other processes unchanged, which of the following statement is true for the modified cycle? So there are four options given. COP is lower than that of original cycle. Refrigeration effect is lower than that of the original cycle. COP is higher than that of the original cycle. COP is the same that of the original cycle. The answer is COP is higher than that of the original cycle. So the when the throttling process is replaced by isentropic process, the COP is higher. So we will see how in the next slide. So look at the temperature entropy diagram. For the vapor compression cycle, it is shown by 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 1, 2, 3, 4 is the vapor compression refrigeration cycle. And the 4, 1 is the throttling process. Now all the other process remains the same. Now the throttling process is replaced by isentropic process. For isentropic process, entropy remains constant. So instead of 4-1, the process line will become 4-1 dash. So other process remains constant. When 1 is, now look at here, 4 to 1 is throttling process, 4 to 1 dash is the your isentropic process. Now refrigeration effect equal to 2 to 1 for the previous cycle, vapor compression cycle, 2 to 1. For isentropic process, 2 to 1 dash. So the refrigeration effect is the increasing. And the compressor work input is the same. So refrigeration effect is changing, it is increasing. So COP, so numerator is increasing, for the same compressor work, COP will increase. So that is the answer. So for when the throttling process is replaced by isentropic process, the COP of the cycle will increase. That is the answer to the question. The next question from 1992 question paper, a refrigeration compressor designed to operate with R22 dash can or cannot be operated with R12 because the condensing pressure of R22 at any given temperature is higher or lower than that of R12. So the correct answer is cannot be used. So when the refrigerator compressor is designed for R22, it should not be operated with R12. That is the answer to the question. Next question is from 1993 question paper. Use of the refrigerant R22 for temperature below minus 30 degree Celsius is not recommended due to its good miscibility with lubricating oil, poor miscibility with lubricating oil, lower evaporating temperature, higher compressor discharge temperature. So the answer is higher compressor discharge temperature. So the R22, the use of refrigerant R22 for temperature below 30 degree minus 30 degree Celsius is not recommended due to the higher compressor discharge temperature. The next question from 1997 question paper. The clearance volume of a reciprocating compressor is 100 milliliter and the volume of the cylinder at the bottom dead center is 1 liter. So the clearance ratio of the compressor is 1 by 11, 1 by 10, 1 by 9, 1 by 1.1. So we have to calculate the clearance ratio. So this is the pressure volume diagram of the reciprocating compressor. So here the clearance ratio is clearance volume divided by the swept volume. Clearance volume minus the swept volume, that is V1 divided by V3 minus V1. So the clearance volume V1 is given as 100 milliliter. So the swept volume, total volume is given as 1 liter, that is 1000 milliliter minus 100. So this is equal to 1 by 9. So the answer to the problem is 1 by 9. So the ratio, the clearance ratio for the given cylinder arrangements, given numbers in the of the given dimensions of the cylinder, it is 1 by 9. The next question is a match the list 1 and 2 from 1998 question paper. On the left hand side, list 1, we have liquid to suction heat exchanger, constant volume heat addition, normal shock, ammonia water. And right hand side, we have vapor absorption refrigeration, vapor compression refrigeration, diesel cycle, auto cycle, converging nozzle or converging diverging nozzle. So for liquid to suction, it is vapor compression refrigeration. Next one is the constant volume heat addition, it is auto cycle. Normal shock, it is for the converging diverging nozzle. And ammonia water is for vapor absorption refrigeration system. The next question is for 2003 question paper. A refrigerator based on ideal vapor compression cycle operates between the temperature of minus 20 degree Celsius and 40 degree Celsius. The refrigerant enters the condenser as saturated vapor and leaves as a saturated liquid. The refrigerant circulation is 0.025 kilograms per second. Determine the refrigeration effect and COP of the refrigerator. The enthalpy and entropy values of the saturated liquid and the vapor at these temperatures are given below in the table. So the minus 20 degree Celsius, we have HF, HG, SF, SG. 40 degree Celsius, we have HF, HF, HG, SF, SG, SF, SG. And this is the, so look at here, the refrigerant enters the condenser as saturated vapor and leaves as a saturated liquid. So this is the condition, enters as saturated vapor and leaves as a saturated liquid. So other data we are given here. Now we take the given data. Condenser temperature is 40 degree Celsius, evaporator temperature is minus 20 degree Celsius, mass of the refrigerant is 0.025 kilograms per second. Now this is the condition. So condenser inlet is saturated vapor, condenser outlet is saturated liquid, and this is the temperature entropy and the pressure enthalpy diagram of the refrigeration cycle, vapor compression cycle. Now the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant after compression, so 3, it is the saturated vapor. So from the given data, H3 equal to HG3 equal to 200 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific enthalpy of refrigerant before evaporation, so H1, so H1 equal to H4. So the 4-1 is the throttling process for which enthalpy is constant, so H1 equal to H4. And the 4 is a saturated liquid, so HF4 equal to 80 kilojoules per kilogram. And to find the dryness fraction, we require to calculate H2, we have to calculate the condition of the refrigerant. So S3 equal to S2. So S3 equal to SG3, S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SG2 minus SF2. So the entropy of the wet refrigerant. Then substituting, SG3 equal 0.67, So SF2 equal to 0.07 plus X2 into 0.7366 minus 0.07. So calculating X2 equal to 0.9. So the quality, the drainage fraction of the refrigerant at 0.2 is 0.9. Now we calculate the enthalpy, specific enthalpy of the refrigerant after evaporation. The H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HG2 minus HF2, which is 20 plus 0.9 into 180 minus 20 equal to 164 kilojoules per kilogram. So the coefficient of performance, COP equal to H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2. So substituting 164 minus 80 divided by 200 minus 164 equal to 2.33. And refrigeration capacity or refrigeration effect, RE equal to M into H2 minus H1, which is 0.025 into 164 minus 80 equal to 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram. So the problem is solved. So the X2 value is calculated and we have solved the problem. Now we take up the questions here. The power required to drive the compressor. So M into H3 minus H2, which is 0.025 into 200 minus 164, which is 0.9 kilowatts. Now we take up the questions here. First question, the refrigeration effect is equal to, so we have calculated 2.1 kilowatts. The second question, COP of the refrigerator is, the answer is 2.33. So these are all the two questions connected with this problem. And the answers, we have solved the problem, we have to solve the problem in the rough page given in the answer booklet, and you have to select the correct answer from the given option. The next question is from 2004 question paper. A R12 refrigerant reciprocating compressor operates between the condensing temperature 30 degrees Celsius and evaporate temperature of minus 20 degrees Celsius. The clearance volume ratio of the compressor is 0.03. The specific heat ratio of the vapor is 1.15. The specific volume at the suction of the compressor is 0.1089 meter cube per kilogram. Other properties at various states are given below in the figure. So look at the figure here. This is the pressure enthalpy diagram. So pressure at the condenser is 7.45. Pressure here in the evaporator is 150. So 1.50. It is 1.50. And the enthalpy values are given here. H3 equal to H4. H1 equal to 176. H2 equal to 207. And this is the temperature 30 degree Celsius. And this is the temperature minus 20 degree Celsius. Now we have to calculate. To realize 2 tons of refrigeration, the actual volume displacement rate considering the effect of clearance is, we have 4 options here. We calculate refrigeration effect equal to 2 tons, which is 2 into 3.5 equal to 7 kilojoules per second. Refrigeration effect equal to M into H1 minus H4. So from the given data, what is the refrigeration effect? H1 minus H4. So H1 minus H4 equal to M into 176 minus 65 equal to 7. So the mass of the refrigerant M equal to 0.0631 kilograms per second. Now the actual volume displacement equal to volume equal to mass into specific volume. So 0.0631 into 0.1089 equal to 6.87 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube per second. So this is the answer. So option 1, 6.35 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube per second is the correct answer. That is the volume displacement rate. So this question is from 2004 question paper. The next question is from 2005 question paper. The vapor compression refrigerant cycle is represented as shown in the figure below. With the state 1 being exit of the evaporator, the coordinate system in this figure is PH, TS, PS and TH. So pressure enthalpy, temperature entropy, pressure entropy, temperature enthalpy. So which is the coordinate? So this is what the problem. So for the this is the ideal vapor compression refrigeration cycle for 1 to 2 is the, so this is the 1 to 2 is the evaporator, 2 to 3 is the compressor, 3 to 4 is the condenser, 4 to 1 is the throttling process. Similarly, the pH diagram. So the diagram, what is given here, it is irrelevant to these two. So the actually look at here. So temperature entropy diagram, pressure enthalpy diagram. So this is not matching with the pressure entropy, pressure enthalpy diagram or temperature entropy diagram. leave alone the number coordinate system, then we leave alone 1, 2, 3, 4. But the shape of the diagram, it is not matching with the pressure temperature or pressure enthalpy. So, pressure temperature, it is not available here. So, the diagram given here is temperature enthalpy. Because 3 to 4 is throttling process for which enthalpy is constant. So, this is temperature enthalpy diagram. Next question is from 2007 question paper. Which combination of the following statement is correct? There are four statements P, Q, R, S. A gas cools upon expansion only which Joule-Thomson coefficient is positive in the temperature range of expansion. Statement Q, for a system undergoing a process, its entropy remains constant only when the process is reversible. Statement R, the work done by a closed system in an adiabatic process is a point function. Statement S, a liquid expands through freezing when slope of its fusion curve on the pressure temperature diagram is negative. So, which of the statement is correct? R and S, P and Q, Q R S and P Q R. So, the answer is R and S. Last two statements are correct and they are interconnected. The next question is from 2012 question paper. A refrigerator operates between 120 kilopascal and 800 kilopascal in an ideal vapor compression cycle with R134a as a refrigerant. The refrigerant enters the compressor as saturated vapor and leaves the condenser as saturated liquid. The mass flow rate of the refrigerant is 0.2 kilograms per second and the properties of R134a, the R given here. So, look at the value. So, look at the problem, the refrigerant enters the compressor saturated vapor and leaves the condenser as saturated liquid. So, these two are the conditions given in the problem. So, for the to take the properties of the system. So, the entry of the compressor is saturated vapor and leaving the condenser as saturated liquid. It is normally the ideal vapor compression cycle. So, this blue color shade is the data what is required for solving the problem. And this is the ideal vapor compression cycle. Ideal vapor compression cycle or simple vapor compression cycle. So, for which the outlet of the condenser number 4 is saturated liquid. Inlet of the compressor number 2 is the saturated vapor. So, 1 to 2 is in evaporator. 2 to 3 is compressor. 3 to 4 is in condenser. And 4 to 1 in the throttling process. Now, what is given? Given data, evaporator pressure equal to 120 kilopascal, condenser pressure is 800 kilopascal. All the enthalpy we have to take from the table. So, enthalpy, specific enthalpy at the outlet of the evaporator, H2 equal to HGT equal to 237 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific enthalpy at the outlet of the compressor, H3 equal to H super 3 equal to 276.45 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific enthalpy at inlet of the evaporator, so, H1 equal to H4 equal to HF4 equal to 95.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And refrigeration capacity is RE equal to M into H2 minus H1, which is 0.2 into 237 minus 95.5 equal to 28.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And the power required to drive the compressor, P equal to M into H3 minus H2, which is 0.2 into 276.45 minus 237 equal to 7.89 kilowatts. So, these are all the answers. The question here, we have to calculate. So, first question, the rate at which heat is extracted in kilojoules per second from the refrigerator space. So, we have calculated as 28.3 kilojoules per second. And the power required to drive the compressor in kilowatts is, so we have calculated 7.9 kilowatts. So, these are the two questions connected with the problem. So, first we solve the problem for the given data, for the given condition, the given data. Then we select the appropriate answer for the given question. The next question is from 2015 question paper. The thermodynamic cycle shown in the figure indicates a reversed Carnot cycle, reversed Brayton cycle, vapor compression cycle, vapor absorption cycle. Temperature entropy diagram. So, temperature entropy diagram, definitely it is not a reversed Carnot cycle. So, for Carnot cycle, the temperature entropy diagram is just a rectangle. So, it is not a Carnot cycle. It is not a vapor absorption cycle too. So, for vapor absorption, there is no thermodynamic cycle. And it may be reversed Brayton cycle or vapor compression cycle. So, which is correct? reversed Barytron cycle. So that is the answer, because it is not vapor compression cycle. For temperature entropy diagram, there is no, for the throttling process is not mentioned here. So the correct answer is reversed Barytron cycle. So we stop here, and these are all the books I have published earlier in mechanical engineering subject, and you can refer to it for your preparation. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the gate question paper solution, on the gate question paper, also the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. You please subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better preparation and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box and subscribe the channel, and you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again with another lecture on the refrigeration